So the little Cuban Yosvany Veitía, he's the man they call El Diablo back home. A little bit of devil in his work alongside sheer class. And he faces the Yazidi, Elvin Mamishzada, the power puncher with terrific balance, outstanding patience, and strikes like a cobra when the moment is right. That saw him knock down Mohamed Flissi twice and eventually stop him in the semi-finals. He also opened a cup on Muhammad Ali, who was a little unlucky in the end to go out by TKO in the second round. Two stoppages in just those three fights so far. Not a bad return on your way to a final.
Not at all. I mean, it can go one of two ways for Mamishzada. You could say he's going to be fresh, but also you could say, has he had enough rounds heading into this one? Has he had enough ring time?
That's Bani Veitía versus Elvin Mamishzada. Veitía in the red, Mamishzada, he'll be in the blue. And in place to go better than he has done in World Championships before. He was a bronze medalist in the Youth World Championships 5 years ago, a quarter finalist when he stepped up to senior level. And at the age of 23, he now has the opportunity to improve on last time's bronze medal 2 years ago. Veitía and Argelagos, who won last night despite a scare. He was put on his backside in the closing round by Ahmed Aliyev, but they're very similar in style. They're very, very confident in their own ability.
Yeah, they are similar. They probably do a lot of work together in the gym. Veitía needs to be switched on in this one, and I think straight punches can be the key for Veitía.
Watch Mamishzada, he doesn't sort of throw flurries of punches. He's very, very patient, economical, and then strikes when he sees the gap.
Yeah, you're right, Alex. He doesn't really waste much, does he? He just waits. He's not a typical come forward puncher. He's happy to go on the back foot.
Chance of a Cuba, though. Cuban fans are here in numbers and on their feet, wrapping the chairs that make a thunderous noise. That's the backdrop to this final.
See Veitía, he respects Mamishzada's power straight away. He's not letting too much go at the moment. He's just feeling his way into this one.
It's by far and away the furthest that Mamishzada has gone. He's got lots of experience, actually. He turns 24 in December, but this is fourth World Championships. Went out in the very first round 6 years ago, and then quarter-finalist at each of the last renewals. Here he is, into a final, and with a chance of glory.
It's good for Mamishzada, just doubled up from body to head with the right hand. Caught Veitía unawares. Veitía is going to be looking for the counter. That's what he does so well, and he warms into bouts, Veitía. He seems to get better as the bout progresses.
Both of them with that vital WSB experience. There's no doubt that Veitía has the much, much classier resume. He's only lost twice in 19 bouts, would you believe? One of those in this year's final. He won the main bout, the final, in 2014.
No blow.
Much in this.
It isn't. They're both trying to draw each other into making a mistake. It's a real chess match. Good jab there from Veitía.
Yes, and Mamishzada is a style, as we head into the final 30 seconds, that does to a large extent court close decisions. His output is economical, if you're going to look at it positively.
And he does make the opponent think constantly as well, because there's always the threat of them big shots coming in. I think Veitía's jab started working quite well towards the end of the round. That left hand there, good shot, may have won him the round.
Nice little flurry there from Mamishzada to close the show in that round. But did he do enough in the previous 2.5 or so minutes?
Difficult to tell in that one. Mamishzada thrown more shots, that for sure. He was leading off.
And the judges seemingly like that as well. So Veitía is going to have to come from behind. It was a tentative start. It was a tight contest from the outset. Will the pattern change? As it stands, Mamishzada is in pole position.
Well, now Veitía is going to have to go looking for Mamishzada. And that's when you can walk onto one of them big shots he throws over the top. So Veitía is going to have to be switched on with his attacks.
Well, Mamishzada beats Picardi, the Italian, Vincenzo Picardi, in Baku earlier on this year when he took gold. Picardi undone by Muhammad Ali in a really good bout in the second round earlier on in this competition.
Mamishzada's boxing well though, really, isn't he? He's taking the centre of the ring now. He's showing good head movement. He's feinting, keeping that Cuban boxer pink and constantly putting him on the back foot now. Good body shot.
Yeah, I think he's really blossomed as the competition has gone on. We've not seen all that much of him, given the fact that previous bouts have only gone about a round and a half, two rounds, a couple of them. But I think he has developed his style. We've got more of a chance to see it. He's quite impressive in his way.
Yeah, he started this round really well.
He went for the right hook to the chest, and Veitía was quick to respond with a counter left.
Stop! No blow. Ball!
He's changed his tactics from round one. Round one, he was happy to wait for Veitía to come to him. But now he's walking the Cuban down and letting his own combinations go.
And he managed to get them off there with the two-punch combination out of distance again.
Good right hand there, Yazabijan. He's stealing points, he's firing in and landing the single shot, and Veitía isn't responding.
And it's almost a national role reversal here. You'd expect the Cuban to be backs against the ropes and fleet-footed, drawing the counters. It's completely the other way around. Veitía is having to come forward now as we head inside the final minute.
He really is having to change his way of thinking now. The Cuban normally happy to let the boxer come onto his shots, and now he's got to go looking for Mamishzada, who's getting that right hand off well while the Cuban's on the way in. He's just dipping the right shoulder and firing it into the body.
He's quite cute, Mamishzada, he really is. Little flooded there from Veitía.
Yeah, but better from Veitía that.
And that jab.
Needs to be. The jab's working well for him, isn't it, when he's using it?
That's been a classy response from the Cuban. But is it enough after the work of Mamishzada through the first part of the round?
Jab again when he's using it, so it's a good weapon to find his range. Let that power shot go.
He landed about five jabs in a row, and he nods his head as he goes back to the corner. Veitía, is that rally enough? Because there was so much good work through most of the round prior to that by Mamishzada.
It's a 3-minute round, isn't it? And I'd say for 2 minutes and 20 seconds, Mamishzada done the more work for me.
And the judges like that. Mamishzada taking the the judges' eyes on all three of the scorecards, and he has one hand on gold. Although, given what we saw light fly last night and again at bantamweight with Argalagos and Michael Conlon, you don't want to be saying that too early.
No. What he does, or what he can do in this round, he can more or less coast his way to the gold medal, and because he can move his feet, Mamishzada, he can skip around the outside of the ring and go from side to side and make Veitía miss. So, you know, he doesn't need to go looking for him this round.
I think he's much better than we thought he was.
He is, isn't he? Surprised me tonight, to be honest.
I think he's got better and better. He really has blossomed in the at the business end of the competition. He's come alive at the semi-final and final stage when it mattered most. I think we have an emerging talent in the shape of this soon-to-be 24-year-old.
He slips shots well. He just moves his head. He's got a good upper body movement. Yeah, he's doing what I thought he might. He's just backpedaling, and he's going to see this round out without really having to do much at all.
He did box with his back to the ropes for periods in the previous rounds. Veitía's going to have to let it all hang out. Taps his gloves as if to motivate himself, the Cuban.
Yeah. And it is role reversal, like you said, Alex. The Cuban isn't used to this. I don't think where he's having to cut the ring down and be the attacker. And Mamishzada can do it well. He's obviously adequate at it.
Well, Veitía has experienced all sorts of different styles, not just in World Championships, where he's been a couple of times, as well as that youth event, but he has won in Hungary, he's won in Romania as well. He's encountered a few different styles, but he just can't cop on to this lad.
Well, we're halfway through the round, and Mamishzada's thrown no more than six punches, and he must be confident that he won them first two rounds, but he may even know.
A bit of cheeky holding on there from Mamishzada as well.
Spun off well there as well, didn't he? So he's got more to his game than what we thought.
There, a couple of accurate shots from the Cuban.
Mamishzada switched to southpaw now, and he's even getting shots off from that stance.
Yes, there's that jab of Veitía. Just landed a couple of punches prior to that. He's starting to put it together again at the end of the round.
It's Veitía winning this round by being on the front foot and trying to force the issue, because Mamishzada is really willing to engage in this round. You can smell that gold medal. You can almost touch it.
It's a shame, because he might have just been able to put a stamp on it, an exclamation mark, with how he was boxing in the previous two.
That really would have been a statement, a 3-0 victory.
Two-punch combination again from Veitía, who has pretty much dominated this round.
That defensive work from Mamishzada impressed me as well, just that little movement with the head. Making shots go over the top of him.
And in the closing 10 or so seconds, Mamishzada decides to come forward. I think he thinks he'd done enough. Veitía with a rally, but I think it was too little too late.
Yeah, I think it was a little bit late for the come forward, but it was only because Mamishzada decided that he didn't have to do much in that round, that Veitía didn't walk onto many shots, because he would have. Because Mamishzada proved that in round two.
He just pointed up to something, Mamishzada. I don't know if that was the big screen or someone in the crowd when he was in between rounds there. Interesting.
Okay. Yeah, you don't know what's getting relayed to them, do you?
They've got a big screen on every corner. I don't think they're relaying the scorecards up there. Here we go.
The winner on points and 2015 52 kilogram world flyweight champion from the blue corner, representing Azerbaijan, Elvin Mamishzada.
A shake of the head from the Yosvany Veitía as the Cuban earns only a silver medal, but I think he's been beaten on merit tonight by a clever cookie, and Azerbaijan have their fifth world championship gold medal in their history. The name, Elvin Mamishzada.
Thought he deserved that. And he looks so laid back at the end of it, doesn't he? He's like, you know, just shrugged his shoulders type of thing. So he obviously fancied himself to do the job.
Yeah, there's something no frills about him, isn't it? Business-like. Another day at the office. I've grown to like him more and more and more. When I saw him in the second round after he got his bye, I think there was much to him. The Ali first round, I thought he lost, although he got it on the scorecards and then that cut. So we didn't get enough chance to see him in that round. But he has just got better and better when it mattered.
He has, and I think Ali can take, you know, consolation from his back.